The AnyCubic Castle is my first Delta-style 3D printer. I got it from the online dealer Gearbest and my part of the deal is this review video. The printer is shipped as a kit. The build instruction comes as print version in English, even worse than mine. A screwdriver and hexagon tools needed for the assembly are part of the kit. The aluminum bars of the construction are covered with metal chips from the fabrication and you should have a close look if none of them has entered the hot end. The assembly is a bit fiddly, for example I had to grind the edges of the rectangular nuts used as mount points at the aluminum bars. All in all, the fitting accuracy of the parts isn't bad, considering that this is a low-cost printer. Wiring is done through plugs with reverse polarity protection, only the wires running to the hot end are connected on the main board by screw terminals. The external power supply has a power switch on the DC side. The adapter at the AC side doesn't fit into German socket outlets. It's no big deal to replace the plug, which is the better solution than any adapter. After turning the printer on, the info screen is displayed. Delta printers use three stepper motors, each of them moving a carriage in vertical direction. The printhead is linked with those carriages through six pushrods. All three motors must turn to move the printhead along the x-axis. The math behind the coordinate transformation is done by the microcontroller. The motors also turn with different speeds to move the printhead along the y-axis. Whenever the printhead moves along the z-axis, all motors turn with the same speed. An advantage of the Delta design is that each of the three linear drives moves less than the printhead does when commanding the nozzle from the right to the left side of the print area. While the printhead moves for 110mm, none of the linear drives moves for more than 50mm. With that type of kinematics, the printer can move the nozzle with high acceleration, as we will see later in the video. There is a warning on the print bed, however, this low-cost version of a 3D printer has no heated bed. Furthermore, the print bed is not adjustable, which is why leveling the printer is very time-consuming when following the steps of the build instruction. I did it my way. First of all, home the linear drives through the printer menu. Now, the printhead is commanded down from 300mm to the zero position. Even if it takes a long time to move the printhead for those 300mm, you must do the movement stepwise, or else the firmware returns to the main screen and the printhead doesn't stop when reaching the adjusted height. When the zero position is reached, there must be a small gap between tip of the nozzle and print bed. Adjust that gap by moving the end switches along the bars. Make sure that the distance between end switch and upper edge of the printer is equal for all three switches. Repeat that procedure until no more than a sheet of paper fits between nozzle and print bed. The fine-tuning is done with the screws on top of the linear drives. You can also use stripes of paper underneath the print bed to fine-tune the printer. As you can see, the nozzle still hits the print bed when moving to the left, while the gap gets larger when moving to the right. With that you won't be able to use all of the print area, however that movement is sufficient to print new, adjustable mounts. After preheating the hot end to 180 degrees Celsius for PLA, and inserting filament, until a strand of plastic comes out of the nozzle, the printer is prepared for its first job. You can clearly see that the print bed isn't leveled correctly, the layer height is definitely lower at the front than at the rear. That's why the first layer is printed with the maximum height of 0.35 mm to compensate for the unleveled print bed. The following layers are printed with 0.15 mm on top of a now leveled surface. I found the design of the mounts on Thingiverse, however I did a redesign in OpenSCAD in order to change the dimensions to meet my requirements. Besides the clamps, 6 nuts are needed to make the print bed adjustable. The thread is designed with layer height in mind to get best results while printing. The knurled nuts fit on the thread as they come out of the printer, at least after the third iteration of the design parameters. Using zero tolerance between the inner and outer thread was a bit over-optimistic. After replacing the bed holders with the new, adjustable ones, the end switches have to be shifted once more so that the nozzle doesn't touch the print bed at zero position. This time we only need a very rough adjustment, the gap between tip of the nozzle and print bed must be something like 5 mm, and another good thing is, it's the last time the switches are moved. Now, bed leveling is done as usual. The print head is commanded close to the mount points, and with the knurled nuts, the gap between nozzle and print bed is reduced step by step, until nothing but a sheet of paper fits tightly between both parts of the printer. All adjustments done? No. If you drive the print head to the center of the print bed, the gap gets smaller and smaller until the nozzle touches the surface. To get this fixed you must change a variable in the source code of the firmware that's on the SD card. Open the file anycubiccosl.ino with the Arduino development environment. The parameter to be changed is Delta Smooth Rod Offset and it is located in the type configuration.h. As seen before, the nozzle is closer to the print bed at the center position, thus I must lower that value step by step. To send the new code to the printer, you must select Arduino Mecha 2560 as board type. I am using Ubuntu Linux. Thus, the port is named DevTTY-USB0. With a mouse click, the software gets compiled and transferred to the printer. You can keep yourself busy for hours or days with fine-tuning the printer and diving deeper into the subject of Delta Kinematics if you'd like to, however there is nothing more to be done to operate the COSL. Here I am printing a test pattern with a diameter of 140 mm consisting of a single 0.35 mm layer. You can see that the nozzle doesn't touch the print bed and the filament sticks on the surface, however the front position should be raised slightly. Now the printer is prepared for jobs and for future adjustments you have to do nothing but turn the knurled nuts to level the bed. When printing a bit faster than before, I noticed that the extruder motor is skipping while moving the filament into the hot end. This motor should be more powerful. I have raised the phase current to get a higher torque. I turned the potentiometer on the driver board of the extruder motor from half to 3/4 of the maximum current. More is too much because the driver chip will get too hot, which also causes skipping. I also cleaned the hot end by what the friction was clearly lowered. The Anycubic Cosl is very sensitive to clogging because of the weak torque of the extruder motor. The four parts of this print occupy an area of 95x70mm and as you can see, all parts stick perfectly on the surface of the print bed. Printing the adjustable bed holders was the first improvement of the Cosl design using the printer itself. Here I am printing mounts to get the filament spool on top of the printer. As mentioned before, the printhead of a Delta printer can be moved with high acceleration. The extruder moves very fast between the gaps of the parts. In contrast, the print speed must be lower than the rated maximum because of the weak extruder motor. I could not get more than 30mm per second with a 0.2mm layer height. With the filament spool on top of the printer, the device occupies just a small area on your desktop. Furthermore, you don't need four hands to move the printer around with the filament loaded. With the compact design, you can also carry the printer with you easily. Delta printers are a class of its own. As shown in detail, the adjustment of a Delta printer is very tricky, thus this is no device for a beginner in 3D printing. An advantage is the compact, robust design. Delta printers are somehow cool. You can see full resolution photos of my sample prints on my project pages to get an impression of the print quality. Here I am printing linear bearings, same as all 3D printers, the Anycubic Cosl is a great tool for prototyping. I will show in coming videos and on my project pages what machines you can build using linear bearings, linkages and more constructional elements. Thanks for watching and I'll be back!